Good, very early morning. We're so glad you're here. We daily vlog. So if you enjoyed today's Run Disney half marathon video, make sure you come back tomorrow, 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 and tomorrow. For a reason unbeknownst to me, they're opening up the grounds 30 minutes earlier today. So yesterday was 3 o'clock, today it's 2:30. So it's 2:24 right now. I'm here even earlier than yesterday. Got me a Pop-Tart, got my gels, got my headbands, got my all the things. Checked into my flight. It's a little chilly, but also over here now. But at Megan and Katie's apartment, and on the drive-in, you could just tell how muggy it was. It is. So that might throw off some of my plans during the race, but there's many factors when it comes to running a race. How you slept, how you ate, how you hydrated, the temperatures, all these things are factors, and some of them you can't control. So we'll see. All right. The map for the half, they just kicked on the music. There's the finish line. Carolyn and her cousin are on the bus now, heading this way. I need to find me some coffee and water. Interesting. So I've never seen this before. They're having the star groups coming in different locations. So one and two will go in there that way. It looks like they're already staged to line up with the start line already. And then the other 3, 4, and 5, they'll be over here, and then they will like corral you slowly down to line up. I have to go, interesting. I don't know why they're doing different, but that works. Got my Joffrey's and a bottle of water. And it is half marathon morning. Look at this, look at this. Boom, I am here so early. It's my song. It's 3:45. I'm gonna go in soon, try to find a porta potty. Get ready. The nerves are growing. The nerves are growing. All right, I'm past the corral running point for like runners only. I'm gonna find a porta potty. I had to say goodbye to Carolyn and her cousin because I'm not gonna see them because I need to run. We're in different corrals, and I have to leave the moment I cross that finish line. So, it's a little sad. We don't know when we're gonna see them next, but we might do something for St. Patrick's Day together. But porta potty corral. It is 4:01, we have an hour. I got my gels. So, time to just sit and be antsy and try to fight the nerves, but they are here. All right. They set it up a little differently this year. I've never seen it set up like this for the corrals, but we already have corral one. I mean, I've seen this over at, where was it? Magic Kingdom, when they had it set up like this, where we're already lined up, aligned with the start line.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light, or the land of the free and the home of the brave?
All right, we had a little delay, but we are moving on to the start line officially. About to start the half marathon. Finished the runDisney Princess Challenge. This isn't a damn beautiful sunrise. I don't know what is. Almost done with the half marathon. Coming up on mile marker 11. I tried to finish in under 2 hours, but I know that's not happening. It's a lot more humid than I was hoped for. From the start, I knew that. But I thought I'd still go for it, and I caught real close. I'm gonna finish strong. I missed my 10 mile 10 marker shot for you guys to let you know that all I had was a quick 5K luck. Because 10 years ago today, we lost. We lost that his dad, and he was a man who ran fast, he's a man who ran slow, he's a man who just ran, he's a man who just walked. And I'm gonna finish this half marathon. When I put this phone down, I'm gonna run in this last 2 miles. And I stopped at that point. I acknowledge I wasn't finishing the 2 miles at the top of this hill because the sun was coming up over Epcot, and I felt, you know what, Sarah's mom and dad would want me to enjoy this view. Where I've been trying to bust it these last 2 miles at a speed that would only probably hurt me if I actually got to it. So, it's been 10 years since we said goodbye to Sarah's dad. It's been like 9 months since we said goodbye to Sarah's mom, but I hear their voice in my head every single day, especially on days like today when I run for them, when I run for Teddy, when I run for James, when I run for Sweet Pea, when I run for Sarah, and all of you guys who help us fundraise for American Cancer Society. So thank you for all these years for this important cause and something very close to us. I see the mile marker 11 right a few yards in front of me, so I'm a mile short, but let's go for a quick 5K.
Keep it going!
Woo! A little sneaky peek of more flower and garden flowers.
Determination!
Woo! This looks like it's the stuff that goes in Italy. Look how cute Mickey and Donald look here. Woo! Hitting 20K. Look at that, a monorail and a sun rising in Epcot. Beautiful. Get ready for this. Get ready. Ready? 3, 2, 1, boom. Woo! Let's finish looking at Jeff Galloway himself. Woo!
Look at the pastries right there.
Here we go.
Too, and look, I like how some of the flowers spin. Very cool. Oh, her face is missing a little paint, but that's okay.
This runner's finishing strong. It's wonderful to see.
Woo! I'm going this way. I don't know if they'll let me leave this way because it's not technically towards the exit. It's towards the entrance, but I want to see Ben because I won't see him if I just leave. And he just got dropped off by an Uber. So we're hoping to pass each other as he comes to watch Carolyn and Beth finish while I leave.
Good morning. We just got all our goodies from Wolf's. We'll show you when we get to the Sicard. Are you so excited? Did you get a shamrock cookie for being so good? They were so nice to him in there. Tuesday is Poonchki Day, so we gotta get our order in. Alrighty, we got cookies. They're all green for St. Patrick's Day. Doesn't it just make you feel like spring is around the corner? They gave us a shamrock cookie because James was such a good kid. Cinnamon pull apart. This is my dad's favorite. I got all kinds of donuts. There's some Bismarcks, a sprinkle, a sugar twist. That's what I would always eat as a child. And chocolate frosted cake and some Boston cream.
All right, so it's 8:37. Made it back to Megan and Katie's. So I'm gonna take a shower, change, get my bags ready, and then leave hopefully by 9 to head to the airport because my flight's at 11:50. So we should have plenty of time. So if we leave at 9, that's 3 hours before the plane. So we're looking good there. I just need to get myself cleaned up. My legs are feeling it after pushing it for, I pushed it for almost, like as I just said, like 11 miles. I was just before the 11 mile mark before I like finally took a step back. I was like, okay, we're gonna shift down gear for the last two. But it was a really good race. I always say it and I'll say it again. And I still, the last 2 days proved it again that to me, Princess Weekend is the most fun weekend of all the runDisney events. I just think there's a vibe and like an atmosphere that is unlike any of the other themed weekends. And as of right now, I've done all of the themes except for, like that'll change. I'm not doing Springtime Surprise. So I won't know how that goes. I'm sure that's gonna be great because it's all like nostalgic races, but I just think there's just something really cool in the air for Princess, in the corrals, in the cheering, in the costumes, and the groups that come, and the families that come. It's just really great. So I'm really glad we were able to make it work. Thank you, Sarah, for supporting me and coming down too. But I'm gonna get ready so I can come back home to you, and James, and Teddy, and Eve, and everybody.
Got a mohawk today, Jamesy?
Do you know where this is and this beautifulness? Boom, I am at the airport. All right, the airport is very, very busy today, but I got a little snack, bottle of water and a Red Bull, and our plane's about to be boarding here in the next like 15 minutes. So don't know what I'm gonna do in the plane. Might sleep, might watch a movie, but I'll be excited to rest for 3 hours.
Got Mr. Potato Head. We watched Toy Story 3, because that was one of my dad's favorites. He would watch over and over again. Now we have on The Dark Knight. Jamesy has on Luca's Woody hat. And I don't know if he's ever been happier in his whole life. I'm shocked. He usually doesn't like to wear hats. Alrighty, we have arrived at O'Hare to pick up Peter. James is asleep, but we're so, so, so excited.
And just like that, we're back in Chicago. That's what roughly 48 hours of runDisney looks like. So I made the comment when we flew down here, but this is from Home Alone. Famous scene in this hallway, them running down late to their flight.
Wow.
Doesn't this look better?
You're crazy. I feel like I say that every clip, but it's just the reality right now.
Because it is crazy every clip.
You had your Susie sandwich. We made like a big sandwich like my mom would make.
It was delicious. It tasted like hers.
Yeah, and there's plenty of Snicky Snacks.
I know, I can't wait to get back in Snicky Snack.
And we actually talked about watching Snow White because we were telling Violet that, like, my mom's favorite princess is Cinderella. And I was
much quieter instead.
I was like, do you know Grandpa's favorite? And we said Snow White. And Violet's like, we should watch that movie next. So I think that's the plan. And maybe take a nap.
Maybe we'll see. There's my baby and he's asleep. Well, he'll wake up when we get him out.
Yeah, he's very active. He can walk now and it's tiring.
Oh, good job.
It's a balmy 43 degrees. Are you in a car?
I was in one weather today.
You were in humidity.
Warm.
So we decided to go on a stroll to Honorary Abbey Road. This is the street that the Olympian, the U.S. Olympian Abby, who played on the women's hockey team, lives. And so they've done up the block all patriotic, and they actually named it Abbey Road. So we're gonna go look at the sign. Everybody's got USA flags up. They got a Beijing flag up, all decked out. Go Abbey sign. So 92nd and Ridgeway now is Abbey Road. That is so cool.
Oh,
Yeah.
With a flag, it's an American flag.
The movies have continued with Forrest Gump. I think we're going to switch over to Snow White, though, since Violet and all of us want to watch it.
We got a fan over here. Vivi gave me some ice cream. I forgot to show how cute Jamesy's shirt is. It's definitely very much so like his grandpa. Mickey and Silly. Pizza, yeah.
This is my pizza. I don't know what your pizza is.
Mmm. Don't mind Christina's construction windows. That's all. That's everyone's pizza, Uncle Peter.
We get home and James grabbed my keys off the table and just walked over and started doing this cute thing that he's always done, sticking the key in the side of the fan.
I actually had to unpack Rex to give him a carry-on, but it's time to go give Rex to James and see if he likes it.
I didn't know it talked.
Ah! Were you scared? Tell me honestly.
Oh my goodness.
I know I am guilt.
What?
Oh, I'm going for fearsome here, but I just don't feel it. I think I'm just coming off as annoying.
Do you like him? Press this button.
I don't like confrontations. I am the dominant predator.
Yay.
Good morning. We did not sign off last night. We crashed hard. So we ate dinner. I think that might be the last clip that we have. Hold on, you gotta see Jamesy real quick. What are you doing? That's quite the trick. You got no shirt on. Is that silly? We got extra thin and crispy pizza from Palermo's, which is my dad's favorite. I'll put in a picture here. I don't think I took a clip of it, but the South Side of Chicago is actually far more well known for their thin crust pizza than like deep dish, the way that like Chicago is known for. So yummy. Palermo's is like has like sweeter sauce. And Peter had literally been awake since like 12:45 a.m. Chicago time. So after dinner, we came home, put James to bed, and then we went to bed too. Overall, it was a really special day. Peter not only got to run in honor of my dad and my mom at the half marathon, he did such a good job, but he also got to come home and spend time with us. If you had noticed, I was wearing a Yankees shirt. It was actually a Lou Gehrig shirt that I had, I got from my parents when we cleaned out the house, and my dad's absolute favorite baseball player was Lou Gehrig. We actually, like, our computer room growing up was our Lou Gehrig room, and it had all of his memorabilia that he had collected over the years. My dad was a huge, huge, huge Lou Gehrig fan, so I wore that in honor of him. James had his silly Mickey Mouse shirt on for him as well. And overall, it was just a simple day that we were able to just do what we always do and honoring him and you know, eating his favorite foods and watching his favorite movies. Alrighty, happy Monday, and it is good to be home.
We know what our goals are. We know what we hope to accomplish. And believe me, it's the most exciting and challenging assignment we've ever tackled at Walt Disney Productions.